to the law of the sea.
Oh, yeah. Well, basically, the system that they operate is a maritime system. We refer to, obviously, the distinction between the two types, the corporate side, the corporate structure, which is maritime law, and the common law one. Now, the common law you can use, this is, it's applicable to everyone. This is a race, colour, religion, because it adopts various names. It can be common law, it can be natural law, law of the land, universal law, the creator's law, even God's law. The same terms and conditions apply for each one. Now, in relation to maritime, they use different things as well, based on maritime and Roman law and things like that, but the terminology they use the same. It's all down to shipping. Hundreds of years ago, they had actually, the only laws they had effect between countries was the shipping maritime laws, because they actually traded with other countries. And because they had something set up there, they then tried to use this on the land and enforce it on the people. But what they did is they actually used the language through maritime law in everyday life. So, for example, you have something like a ship or a vessel. It says, we'll come into dock. Now it comes into dock, it says, which is obviously the dock you have in court as well. So you come in to answer, and obviously you come in to dock and berth in a quay. Now, when they berth, it says what they do is they come in, berth, and then they unload a cargo. Well, that is the terms that's used for delivering a child, because the mother will go into berth, and when she goes into berth, she will then obviously deliver a cargo. The cargo she delivers is the child, it's property, it's treated as cargo. And when the cargo, seemingly like the on a ship or a vessel, when they actually deliver a cargo, there's a manifest. So they actually draw up the manifest for the cargo and a note is taken. When a mother goes in to give birth, she goes into a birthing suite. She then delivers a cargo, which is a child. This property is delivered and is treated as property. And then there's a birthing manifest. Well, that's a birth certificate. So the birth, the child becomes the property, and it's all registered through the birthing manifest, which is the same as the shipping manifest, is delivering a cargo. So they're delivering a cargo into the system. That's the way it works. You have other issues. This is everyday life. It's just a terminology. You have the banks. The banks use it. Now, if you look at maritime laws, this is in relation to banks. Well, banks, you have banks on the river. It says also you have a water flow. You have a current. Current becomes currency, which is money. So to control the current, the currencies, you have the banks to prop them up at either side and keep an eye on things. Well, that's the same with the banking. They actually have, they've adopted the term bank, so they then restrict and control the flow of money in this case. So they use the same terms as if for maritime law in everyday life. And it's only when you actually find out about it and how they use it, you then understand how they work. But the distinction is, if they're doing that, it's to know that this exists, to know that they operate it, and then it comes down to the basic principles. You have a choice. Is this acceptable? Do you wish to use it? Or do you wish to establish yourself as a living man? In which case you can claim this is common law or maritime law or even the law of the land. This is in the, why I mentioned that, the terminology for common law, it's applicable throughout. You've got common law, as we've said just now, this is, you've got natural law, universal law, the creator's law, God's law. It is also the law of the land, which is the opposite of maritime law, because it's for land dwellers, which takes you back to living men and women. So this is how it works. But there's a two distinctions here.